In this example, we are given that a particle starts at initial speed of 17 meters per second and it retards at 2 meters per second square. And we are required to find the distance covered by the particle in 9th second of motion. We just draw the physical situation in this question. We are having a particle at t equal to 0, it starts with an initial speed of 17 meters per second and is retarded with an opposite acceleration of 2 meter per second square. So gradually its speed will decrease and after some time its final velocity becomes 0. And we can easily calculate the time at which its final velocity is becoming 0. Say this time is t1. So we can simply write the equation v final as u plus at. So here 0 can be written as 17 minus 2 t1 because acceleration will be minus 2 in this case. So here we can see the time t1 we are getting is 17 by 2, that is 8.5 seconds. So at t1 equals to 8.5 seconds, it is coming to rest. And then it will return back because acceleration was opposite. So till this point, what will happen? Its velocity is retarded, it will come to rest and then it returns back due to the continuous action of acceleration and now it will be in a accelerated motion. Now in this journey, we are required to find the distance covered by the particle in 9 seconds of motion. If we calculate the distance by using the formula for displacement of nth second or displacement of particle in nth second, just see what will happen. You'll be able to have a look on an interesting result. The formula for nth second of motion was u plus a by 2 into 2n minus 1. So here we are required to analyze the motion in 9 seconds. So we find out the displacement in 9 seconds of motion. This will be 17 plus a by 2. This will be minus 2 by 2 into 2 into 9 minus 1. Just see what you are getting. This 17 minus, this is 1 and this 18 minus 1 is 17. The result is 0. Now it is quite a surprising result how it is possible that displacement becomes 0. Yes, it is possible because you can see we are required to analyze the motion in 9 seconds. So 9 seconds will be the duration from t equals to 8 to t equal to 9 seconds of motion. This is the 9th second. So we can see at 8.5 second, the particle was at rest. It is the extreme position. So if it is at this position at t equal to 8 second, it will take 0.5 second in going from this point to this point. And similarly, as we analyze the accelerated motion with same acceleration, it will take same time, that is 0.5 second going from this point to this point back. So here it will reach at t equal to 9 seconds. So you can see at t equals to 8 and 9 seconds, the particle was at same position. That's why the result is coming out to be 0. Because this is the formula for displacement in 9 seconds. It is not giving us the distance. And in the question, it is asked to find the distance covered. So that we can easily calculate by finding out the distance covered by the particle from rest within 0.5 seconds and we make it twice. So, if this distance is S1, this S1 can directly be written as half AT square as initial speed here is 0. So, this is half into 2 into 0.5 whole square. So, this is 0.25 meter. So, we can directly write distance covered in 9th second is this 2S1 that is equals to 0.5 meter. Which is the answer to this question. So be careful about such type of questions which are slightly tricky, but several times it happens that students without any analysis or without any thinking, they just apply the direct formulas and they ignore such type of language in the question. So be careful in future about such type of questions.